Hello, everyone, and thanks for joining us. Two Hennepin County commissioners want to change who controls the Hennepin County Crime Lab.
And they want to move the management from the sheriff's office to the county administration. County commissioners met this Wednesday afternoon to discuss the matter, and reporter Sonia Goins is live with more on what they had to say. Sonia?
Mike and Alex, even before the committee meeting got started, officials with Robbinsdale and Crystal spoke out against the matter. They are concerned that the new changes could have a negative impact on how they process crimes. Meanwhile, Maple Grove Police Chief Eric Werner spoke during the meeting. He asked the board to table the matter until key issues can be examined. The Hennepin County Crime Lab is a very busy place. Last year, more than 2,400 crime scenes were processed at the facility.
So this crime lab services 44 of the 45 cities that comprise Hennepin County.
Sheriff Rich Stanek is in charge of the crime lab, but Commissioner Marion Greene wants to change that. She recently introduced an initiative to change who's in charge by making it part of the county administration.
Best practice to have a separated crime lab, a crime lab that doesn't report to law enforcement and also doesn't report to prosecution. And the idea is to just have that independence.
But Hennepin County Sheriff Rich Stanek says it's a bad policy and can even hurt investigations.
This will be akin to slowing down the process in terms of response times. The Hennepin County Sheriff's Office also processes property crime DNA. There isn't another crime lab in the state that does that.
Since the county's crime lab is one of a few in the state that does DNA testing in-house for property crimes, Stanek feels changing this to an outside vendor would slow down processing times. Meanwhile, the Brooklyn Park Police Department uses the Hennepin County Crime Lab to process all of its crime scenes.
So we probably are one of the biggest users of the county crime lab unit. So I'd assume at some point they're going to come ask us or at least talk to us about how this would impact us.
Commissioner Greene says one of the reasons for the proposed change is to save taxpayers money.
Especially for Minneapolis taxpayers who are currently paying for two crime labs. Through their Hennepin County property taxes, they're paying for a county crime lab, and then through their city property taxes, they're paying for a city crime lab. Actually, suburban taxpayers will also benefit relatively immediately because both crime labs separately are contracting with the state and with other outside vendors for certain tests.
But Sheriff Rich Stanek disagrees and says the move might be political in nature. The crime lab is next to the Viking Stadium, and he thinks this might have something to do with the proposal.
Since the Viking Stadium was built, they have wanted this land. For all I know, this could be just a ruse on behalf of the commissioner in order to provide that land to the Minnesota Vikings at taxpayer expense.
Commissioner Greene says that's not the case, and she looks forward to hearing from officials in the suburbs.
I really want to kind of reassure Brooklyn Park and other suburbs that we don't see any service change. This is a change in management, if you will.
After a lot of debate, they decided to postpone the vote till December 12th. There were just too many questions that couldn't be answered today. Live in Minneapolis, Sonia Goins, CCX News.